Before planting a garden in a new environment, conduct a lead test to ensure that your soil is safe for gardening and growing food. Minnesota soils are generally low in lead, including most urban soils, but a few factors that influence soil lead concentrations include traffic density, age of homes and buildings, building density, siding type, and the presence or historical presence of industrial processes. Older homes and buildings that have had wooden siding are more likely to have lead paint in the soil near the home's foundation. Lead concentration tends to decrease the further you go from the foundation of a home or building. Even around newer homes and buildings, lead may be present. Areas with tall buildings, high building density, and more traffic are more likely to have trapped lead in the environment. But even in these environments, lead levels vary from site to site. So when are soil lead concentrations too high? Minnesota has a very conservative lead standard. 100 parts per million lead is considered acceptable in bare soil and child accessible areas. The US EPA considers anything below 400 ppm to be acceptable. What is acceptable for you? It depends on your tolerance for risk and how you plan to interact with your soil. If you're using your soil to grow food, consider that vegetables grown directly in the ground, such as carrots, radishes, or potatoes, are more likely to absorb lead or to retain lead-containing soil particles. Growing these vegetables in soil with 300 to 400 parts per million lead is considered moderate to high risk. Foods that grow above ground but have soil contact, such as lettuce, are considered low to moderate risk, and growing foods with no soil contact, such as apples, tomatoes, or sweet corn, is considered low risk with lead levels around 300 to 400 parts per million. No matter what you're growing, washing produce before you eat it will help to prevent the ingestion of soil lead. So how do you test your soil? If you have a distinct growing area, such as a raised bed, take 5 to 10 samples from that spot and mix them together in a bucket or container. Use a small hand shovel, often called a trowel, to collect soil from the top 3 to 4 inches of soil for a lead test, or from the top 6 inches of soil if you also plan to conduct a basic soil test. Make sure to position your trowel downwards in order to collect soil from the top of the soil profile as well as a few inches down. Mix your samples well and remove any rocks. Once the soil in your container is dry and well mixed, fill a plastic bag about half full with your soil, label the bag, and send it to a diagnostic clinic. If you have two distinct growing areas, especially if one is close to a home or building, consider doing two separate samples. Samples can be sent to the University of Minnesota Soils Lab. Instructions and forms are available online. The same sample and form can be used for a basic soil test, which provides nutrient recommendations. Plants take up limited amounts of soil lead, and so your main exposure will occur by actually working in the garden. Children are most at risk because they tend to play more directly in the soil. If your soils are high in lead, one simple solution to minimize risk is to grow in a raised bed garden and to fill the raised bed with lead-free soil. Lead tends to stay buried in the soil profile, so add at least 1 foot of soil to minimize contact with the lead-containing soil below.